Hey everybody, Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com, and welcome to the update for Sunday, April 7th, 2019. Free pick coming up in just a moment for Sunday. First, a quick note, if you've yet to become a member over at DocSports.com, real cool way to give it a trial run you. Click on the link below the video, get set up for a free $60 account. You can use that on any of my daily packages over at DocSports.com, the premium plays, or anybody else's daily packages for that matter at DocSports.com. Again, a trial run means you get a free $60 account, and all you got to do to get started is click on the link below the video. Boy, we got a lot to talk about in just a minute of what's going on for Sunday for us. I've got a huge play in the NBA for Sunday. Several teams do have a lot to play for still. Teams fighting for certain seeds, fighting for the playoffs, all that kind of good stuff going on Sunday. And we'll talk about a little bit of that, but I wanted to mention that in that mix on Sunday with all those games, we do have a big seven-unit play. We haven't had a whole lot of these. This will be, I think it's the third one now, since the middle of March. Won the first two. We're 17-5 with our last 22 NBA plays, up about $3,500 for $100 per unit bettors. We passed last night. Short card, didn't like any of the games. We decided to pass, but we're back in action. In fact, we got two sides. Premium picks over at DocSports.com on Sunday. They'll be available Sunday morning. And again, one of those sides is a big seven-unit play in the NBA. Big main event, NBA game of the month. And again, both plays will be available Sunday morning, DocSports.com. We'll look to extend that run to 19-5, the last real big day, definitely the last Sunday of the regular season. And we hope to build on that run that we've been on thus far. And in fact, going all the way back to January 2nd, we've been doing pretty good in the NBA and look to carry that into the postseason. So that's what's going on, the big play. 2-0 NBA card led by the seven-unit play on Sunday. You know, that's as big as they get for me over at DocSports.com. As far as everything else, NASCAR is posted. You can go grab it right now. Don't forget the race gets underway shortly after 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific. So certainly go over there and grab NASCAR before the race gets going if you're interested in NASCAR. And we've got a few. We've got like five drivers that we're involved with on Sunday, and three of those drivers have double-digit odds. So go check it out if you're interested in the left-turn circuit in NASCAR on Sunday. They're at Bristol, one of my favorite tracks. We've had great success over the past 20 years at Bristol, and I think we're going to do it again on Sunday with our NASCAR card. And that's what we got going on Sunday. Well, we do have baseball also, I forgot to mention. We have a Sunday hammer in Major League Baseball, and we'll look to get that winning streak started on Sunday with one play on the diamond. But again, I can't mention it enough how much we like this play in Sunday's NBA. Again, seven-unit play on Sunday in the NBA, part of a 2-0 package. And again, on that 17-5 run, so be sure to go grab those. Little thought on the Final Four, what we saw on Saturday's slate. Obviously, the controversial ending with Virginia. The play at the end was a foul, no doubt about it. And it was a boneheaded play by the Auburn defender. You don't jump towards a three-point shooter with the clock basically almost at the buzzer, almost at zeros on the scoreboard. And listen, what you do is maybe deke as though you're going to go towards him, and don't. Just give him something as peripheral vision. But man, that's one of those things where you just got to accept. If he makes this three-pointer at the buzzer, shake his hand, great, congratulations, good job, you won. But you do not foul the guy. And then, of course, guy goes to the free throw line and hits all three free throws. Looked like he could have hit 50 in a row if he wanted to. He was so cool. But anyway, Virginia almost looks like a team of destiny now at this point. I mean, my gosh, the way they win against Purdue, the way they won in this game. And it'll be a great matchup on Monday night against Texas Tech, who slammed the door on Michigan State. But I want to go back again. I almost forgot to mention, go back to that Virginia game. You know, they're up like 57-47, 58-48, 4 or 5 minutes to go in the game. And they really did look like they were going to pull away and win by a spread covering margin. And then all of a sudden, Auburn cans four three-pointers in a row. That's the thing about the Auburn Tigers. That's the thing about college basketball, man. If you're recruiting, go get yourself some long-distance shooters, because you're never out of a game if you can make shots. And listen, Auburn didn't have a great day from the three-point line, but when it mattered, all of a sudden, four in a row, and they took that lead over Virginia at 59-57 after being down by 10, again, with 4 or 5 minutes to go in the game. So listen, the one thing about Monday night, I don't think we're going to see a ton of three-pointers from either team. It's been interesting to see the line movement. We saw Virginia open up a 1.5-point favorite. There are now a lot of ones out there. There's still some 1.5s. The total, which was 120, some juice on the over offshore now in that 118 range. I saw as low as 117.5 in one spot. Sold 60% of the tickets as far as the side on Texas Tech, plus the points thus far as we talk about this early Sunday morning. So most of the action on Texas Tech thus far, we saw immediate betting on the under. The one scary thing about betting an under that is that low in such a meaningful game, you know you're going to see a lot of personal fouls. If one team is up by 10 with a minute to go, maybe during the course of the regular season, you don't see a lot of fouling going on. A team accepts its loss, time to move on. But you know in the national title game, with the championship on the line, they'll be hacking away if you're down to whichever team. Down by 10, 1 minute to go, that team's going to be hacking away to send the other team to the free throw line, try to extend the game and get the come-from-behind victory. So that's the scary part about wagering on an under that is this low in a championship game, such a meaningful game. Anyway, there's some of our thoughts on what's going to happen. We'll be back here on Monday morning, by the way. I'll get to the free play in a second, but we'll be back on Monday morning, 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific, with some more thoughts. Hopefully, we'll see some propositions, some prop bets that'll be out there, hopefully by the time we're able to talk again with Monday's video and maybe find a couple of the plays that we can give you right here on this video for Monday night's championship game. And by the way, the 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific thing, listen, I know I've been tardy this week. We've had a lot of videos that haven't gone up to about 2 a.m. Pacific time instead of 1 a.m. We promise we'll get back to getting those up by 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific each and every day of the week, including Monday. And again, if we get those prop plays from a couple of books, I'll be certain to really dissect the prop plays and find a play or two that we think we can sink our teeth into and release those here right here on the videos for Monday. All right, let's get to the free pick in Major League Baseball for Monday. We're going to back Team 921. That is the Seattle Mariners. Basically even money over the White Sox. I'm backing the Mariners with LeBlanc over Nova. Every key category outside of the starters, I break things down by bullpen. I kind of handicap games in a backwards manner. I start with the bullpens, look and see how the teams are doing with batting average, OBP, all that good stuff on offense, how many runs they're averaging per game this season. This portion of the season, I like to go back and see how teams did last season in current spots, like how a team did maybe in a road day game against a lefty, if that's the case or the situation they are in that particular day. So all of that, I mean, just jumps on Seattle in this particular matchup again. And when you look at that bullpen, Sox relievers, boy, their combined ERA is about 7.5 right now, not good. Seattle's better at the plate. They're averaging over 7 runs per game on the season. And listen, they've shocked the hell out of me. I mean, they're plus 22 on the run differential so far in 2019. Last year's team, by the way, also hit well in this spot, averaging 5 runs per game in road day games against righties. So the fact that they're scoring runs in this situation is nothing new. And listen, the Sox so far horrible at the plate in 2018. In day games against Southpaws, they were horrible last year. Listen, it's early, but the pen's not answering the call. I think this is a game that's going to go to the bullpens. And with that in mind, I think Seattle's the play here. With LeBlanc and Nova on the mound, I don't think either pitcher is going to go deep into the game. So we're going to look at the team that hits better, scores better, is playing better, has the better current bullpen, and that is Seattle, and that'll be our free pick, our opinion for Sunday. So Team 921, the Seattle Mariners, and again, your starters are LeBlanc and Nova. And again, Sunday, great card over at DocSports.com right now, led by that 7-unit play in the NBA. We'd like to go to 19-5. With our current NBA run. Don't miss out. Don't miss out on NASCAR and Major League Baseball. All right, listen, if you like these videos, be sure to click on that thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. My name is Scott Spreitzer. I'm at DocSports.com, and we'll be right back here Monday morning, 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific. Let's put Sunday in the win column.